I've been in practice for 10 years, and these are just a few of the ones that I thought I would mention because they've been beneficial for some of the folks that I've worked with and because they don't have as many adverse events associated with them. Number one, omega-3 fatty acids. Many people are not getting these highly beneficial, anti-inflammatory, heart-healthy, brain-supportive omega-3 fatty acids. These are found in your fatty fish, in your oils, walnuts, nuts and seeds, hemp, flax seed, chia seed. And very often people are deficient because they are not eating enough of these foods. So omega-3 fatty acids can be taken in pill form. And this just happens to be a fish oil, but you can also get a vegan source, which is taken from algae oil. A bone complex, a bone supportive supplement that has all of the bone supportive minerals and vitamins that are helpful to prevent osteoporosis and support bone growth and prevent bone wasting. So I like to use or recommend bone strength minerals that are more food grade, things like magnesium and zinc. Very often we're not getting sufficient amounts of these minerals. And not only are they important for our bone health, but they are important for our heart health and our brain health and our skin health. Supplement number three is a B complex. It is a complex formulation of many different B vitamins. Now, your B vitamins are essential for energy production, for neurotransmitter production, for nerve transmission. So they are very, very important for numerous systems of the body. And what's essential, and this is where that quality thing comes in, is that your B vitamins need to be in a form that is active, meaning that your body can actually absorb them. We call this a methylated form of B. What was that? Methylated. So this is important for your brain health. It is important to help bring down levels of something called homocysteine, which is an amino acid that when it's elevated in your blood, can be toxic to the system and put you at a higher risk for heart disease and Alzheimer's. Those B vitamins can help bring that down, bring it down. Also helpful for people who are highly stressed out, which you might be feeling today or yesterday or tomorrow, or who knows what's gonna happen next week. B vitamins have been shown to be beneficial for certain populations who are experiencing high levels of stress. Point four. This is a supplement that maybe you have not heard of, but which I have found highly valuable, which has been shown to have virtually no interactions with any medications or concerns in terms of causing adverse events. And it is called L-theanine. L-theanine is an amino acid. It's found naturally in chamomile tea and in green tea, and it has been shown to calm the nervous system. So again, if you are feeling stressed, if you are feeling like you're having trouble calming yourself down, L-theanine can take the edge off. It can actually help with a neurotransmitter synthesis and help with the nervous system to feel a little bit more at ease. So L-theanine can be helpful for bed, or if you're just feeling on edge, L-theanine in 200 milligrams is a nice place to start. Point number five. This is the vitamin that I told you you might just be deficient in. Vitamin D.
Ooh.
Very important for your immune system, for inflammation, for your brain health. It can be critical for improving your mood. And many people, especially if you live at a latitude where you don't get as much exposure to sun, or if you're slathering SPF on your face all day, or you just don't get outside, you may not have sufficient levels of vitamin D. But make sure you get tested for it before you start popping it, because it's not necessary if you don't need it. And one way that you can get it, if you don't feel like popping pills, is with a little bit of liquid. This is liquid vitamin D. Delicious.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you're taking some right now.
I'm taking some right now because I live in Seattle and there ain't no sun and I haven't been outside all day. So I need a little extra kick. And I know that my levels actually were deficient before.
I think the D might stand for deficiency.
Ooh, vitamin deficiency. Interesting. It solves its own issue.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, that's a great way to end.